Jackson Montessori School.
Assistant coaches Bill Phillips, Corey McRae, Tony.
Jones. And ladies and gentlemen, the head coach of the University of Delaware, Martin Inglesby! University of Delaware, NCAA, made traditions of man's sportsmanship by student-athletes, coaches, and spectators is not one of them. Please appoint them as officials with respect and in a positive manner. Inappropriate behavior will be grounds for removal from the Bob Carpenter Center. We thank you!
Drives inside, a turnover as Mojica dribbled off his legs and out of bounds. Still no score, 17-55.
Delaware really scrambling well defensively. That was a wonderful skip pass there from Moran to Mojica, and Eric Carter did a great job of chasing it down. A big difference in mismatch and quickness and height there.
Carter with the basketball, kick out to Daly, wide open for a three, and it hits the front of the rim, short to Drexel. Nothing score, 17-35, first half. Kennedy on top to Austin Williams. John Moran dribbling to the left side. He brings it in to Mosley. Mosley grips it, jump ball, Delaware's possession.
That's a great job of gap help defense. Anthony Mosley, who I talk about, is terrific on the ball, but that time he did a great job of recognizing Moran dribbling with his weak hand. He dug right into the dribbling area, gets the loose ball tie-up. A really smart play by Mosley to start here defensively.
See if Delaware can't get on the board. Nothing, nothing. Backdoor, Bryant. Bryant with the layup over the shot blocker, Austin Williams, and it's 2-0.
An interesting matchup for Drexel. Rodney Williams playing Ryan Daly. I think they think the height is going to matter a little bit. Delaware, of course, as you know, plays really right now with four perimeter players and just one post in Eric Carter.
Drexel trying to get on the board as Delaware just did. Kennedy straight away at the point. Left side of Moran, ball fake, driving baseline. He stops, pass out to Williams. Austin Williams with a pass over to Kennedy. Kennedy on the wing, left side, three is good. Drexel leads it 3-2.
Ryan Daly just a little slow to get out there on Major Kennedy. Not known for a lot of offense because of his injuries, as you documented, but Kennedy was spotted up well on the left side. A nice skip-through pass.
16-29, first half, 3-2, Dragons lead. Cushing works it to Daly. Daly dribbles to the right side. Dribbles all the way in. Wraparound pass to Carter. Carter misses the layup. Put back is good. Off the window and in.
It was as if Eric Carter wanted to get an offensive rebound there. He kind of missed it to himself, which sometimes is a very smart play by a post player. Perfectly positioned for the putback.
Austin Williams, left block. Working over Cushing. Cushing got a piece and a rebound for Ryan Daly. Daly is second board. Dribbling up the floor, driving right, contact, no whistle, off the window and in for Ryan Daly.
A great job of Daly attacking the shoulder of Moran, who was looking for the charge, but a good job there with a no call and a great job of the backboard usage.
Dribbling into traffic is Mojica, steal by Carter. Bryant on the run, right-handed layup is through, and Delaware in transition forces Drexel to call a timeout. 8-3, Delaware's lead. 15:36 left in the first half, and we'll take a break with Zach Spiker and the Dragons on the Blue Hens Sports Radio Network.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
The Bob Carpenter Center, an 8-3 lead, Delaware over Drexel, and it's the defense that has looked sharp from the Hens.
We've talked about it so many times, the defense of the home court always starts with defense, communication, engagement, knowledge of the scouting report, and you're checking all those boxes right now for Delaware. Mosley, Bryan, Eric Carter doing a good job. We just seem to have a great feel for what Drexel's trying to do against us. Billy Phillips had the scout, did a great job of getting this team prepared.
Kurt Lee in the game for the first time, did not start, but leads the team in assists per game, second in scoring, nearly 15 points a game. Wearing a number 30 jersey tonight. His number one jersey didn't make the trip. Mojica in the corner, a three is good, and just like that, it's a two-point lead for Delaware.
The insertion of Kirk Lee adds additional quickness and ball handling capabilities to Drexel. Great movement and spacing on the perimeter for a wide open shot to Mojica in the left corner.
5 minutes in, Daly with the basketball. Delaware leads 8-6. Mosley on the wing. Screen comes from Carter. Pass over to Daly. Daly back to Mosley. They'll have a catch. Starter still on the floor for Delaware against his Drexel man-to-man. Bryant to the foul line. Tries to bounce into Carter. He bobbles it, collects it, misses it, gets it back, and is fouled. A great effort by Eric Carter underneath. Second time he's followed his shot tonight.
The play was made by Darian Bryant, getting into the lane and not going too deep. He recognized he had Eric Carter rolling down the right side of the lane. Muhammad Ba, who was playing Eric Carter comes up and helps up. Generally not a good maneuver, and a really nice drop-off pass to Eric Carter, who got confronted by some size in there, but finds a way to get his own rebound again. And I just like the fact that Eric, though not establishing that initial move, staying with it because of his positioning and not giving up on the play.
Carter misses the first free throw, makes the second, 61% from the line this season for the big man from Jackson Memorial High School in New Jersey. Kurt Lake bringing the ball up the floor. Delaware leads 9-6. Drexel with the rock, bringing it to the right side as Carter hedges on a screen. They go to Rodney Williams, who's had a quiet start to this game. Just 0 of 1 from the field. Good defense by Eric Carter and some double teaming. Moran brings it to the right side. Kirk Lee, the freshman, driving on Mosley. Step back. Over Champ is good. And off the bench tonight, Kirk Lee making his presence felt almost immediately.
A terrific move. We talked about Kirk Lee's quickness and his knowledge of defense. He did a great job there of stepping back to create space on Mosley, who's typically very good on the ball.
Delaware leads by 1, 9-8. Pinkert in the basketball game for the first time as Cushing comes out at that last whistle. Daly picks up his dribble to Mosley, wing right side, driving on Lee, who just scored against Champ. Off balance runner, off the mark. Daly crashes, fades too strong, and Ba with a rebound for the Dragons. Kirk Lee wants to go. Drexel likes to go fast. Moran in the corner, kick back out to Ba, flips over to Lee. Delaware set defensively now. Moran left open, though. Second three of the night, no good, and a rebound by Drexel. Mosley reaches in and will be called for the foul. That's the first on the Hens.
The insertion of Kirk Lee adds some quickness to the attack of Drexel. It forced Delaware to get back, which they did do a good job of getting five back and confronting. Devon Pinker just a little late on his close out there. Moran, though, he missed the shot badly.
Ba gets the inbound. Reset shot clock for Drexel. 13:30. First half, Mojica dribbling into traffic. Ball loose. Harris coming into the game and getting a steal immediately.
Boy, what a great job. Though he didn't go to the floor, he had his hands first to the floor, created that turnover by Mojica, who has been handling the ball quite well this season.
How about the bigs? Eric Carter has a steal, and Barnett Harris with a steal. Daly corner three, and the freshman misses for the second time, but Harris an offensive rebound. What an impact Barnett has done in just a minute of action so far.
A lot of activity on the weak side of the block by Delaware. Ryan Daly on the possession prior, and Barnett Harris that time just out-hustling Drexel.
Mosley has it poked away along the baseline. Austin Williams gets the steal, a turnover for the Hens. That's their first of the ball game. Lee, no one stops the ball. Floater inside the paint is no good, but a foul is going to be called on the floor. Looks like Harris might have shoved Muhammad Ba, so Harris will be called for his first, the team second, with 12:42 to play first half.
Because Kirk Lee is only 5'10", you'll see him at times, and we'll talk about it, drive into the lane and shoot that mid-range floater. It's a shot that's effective only if you practice it a lot. It's very difficult to get off because of the different angles and where you let the ball leave your hands. But I like the play of Kirk Lee. He's really challenging Delaware's defense.
Pass from the baseline was deflected. It should stay with Drexel. The officials talking things over. From our angle, looks like it hit a Delaware hand. But I believe they're going to, and I'll shut up before the officials come over and hear me talking, but I believe if we were to see a replay, we'd notice that it was deflected by a Delaware player. It's going to be Delaware possession, though, and a turnover for the Dragons.
Officials did not even coordinate that. They just went ahead with the baseline official to make the call, and they, from our standpoint, got it right.
We had a pretty good angle on it. Anthony Franklin decided he didn't need help on it. It's Delaware basketball, the fifth turnover for Drexel. Pinker dribbles around, misses offensive board. Daly, and he powers it up and in. How about the strength shown by the freshman?
Well, we know Daly's like a football player. Drexel does not have anyone to confront him in there right now.
Austin Williams, triple team, passes out. Daly with a steal now. He wants to push, but Drexel gets back. Now some speed across half court. Has a smaller player in Kurt Lee defending. Mosley crossing inside the paint. Contact, no whistle, but the bucket is good for Champ Mosley.
Mosley making a terrific basket cut right to left, attacking the smaller Kurt Lee.
And now another turnover as Drexel, feeling some pressure, throws it out of bounds, and that'll bring us to a break. Delaware leading 13-8. 11:55 to play in the first half on the Blue End Sports Radio Network.
Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there's only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice.
Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
Delaware taking on Drexel for the second time this season. The Dragons had 20 assists, only 8 turnovers the entire first contest up in Philly. Different story so far tonight.
The Delaware defensive concentration is as good as I've seen it all season, including some great home wins. The knowledge of the scouting report, really taking advantage of defensive matchups. So many times players and people talk about the offensive matchup. Right now, Delaware just has the better defensive matchups and is playing to their strengths, creating offense out of it.
Drexel, 7 turnovers so far. The last one brought us to a timeout. Harris, as we resume action, has the ball, left block, passing to Bryant, who cut through, ball knocked out of his hands and out of bounds. So now a turnover for the Hens, their second.
A really good idea. Harris down on the left block. He finds the cutting. Darian Bryant just couldn't quite deliver the pass perfectly, and it required that because of Kirk Lee's defense. But good concept offensively.
Hens lead 13-8, 11-30 first half. Lee with the basketball, trying to get into Ronnie Williams. They do so. Double team comes. He dribbles, passes it to Kennedy. Kennedy steps in from 3, deep 2, no good. And a rebound by Anthony Mosley. He wants to push all the way ahead to Harris, who jumps to get it, saves it to Pinker, but he's fouled as he passed the basketball senior to senior. That's the third on the Dragons.
Terrific subtlety to that play, Scott. Doubled across with Devon Pinkert and Barnett Harris on Rodney Williams per the scouting. They kick it to an open major Kennedy. Barnett Harris attacks him and then leaks out. Darian Bryant trying to reward him with a long full court pass to try to lead to a score.
Daly off the inbound. He's going to set the offense and found himself open to drill a 17-footer. It's 15-8. Delaware leads.
Ryan Daly's got a quick release and senses at times when the defense is playing a little low on him and rises up with the shot, even though it might be early in the shot.
Currently with the basketball inside to Williams again. Double team comes. 13 to shoot. He dribbles around the double team. Strong take to the rim. And it's only so long that you can contain Drexel's leading score at 16.6 for the bucket and the foul there.
But Rodney Williams has done intelligently on two of the doubles. He's a retreat dribble to reverse the ball. Devon Pinkert is coming to help. Left his feet a little early, and that allowed Rodney Williams to find the gap in the double team and then attack.
See some substitutions for Delaware. Pinkert and Harris will check out. Carter back in. Corbett in the game for the first time. We thought we might see some more minutes from Chavarsky. Corbett, for the lone fact that he was out there warming up for about an hour before the game was ready to go. Looked like a guy that wanted to be out there playing some minutes. Over to Carter as the free throw no good from Willingham. 18 seconds on the shot clock. Daly left alone, but bobbled the catch and passes to Bryant. 12 to shoot, deep right side for Bryant. Stops just inside the arc. A pass to Mosley. Wing right side, deep 2 for Champ. Strong and a rebound by Kirk Lee. It's kind of the only way the 5'10 point guard can get those rebounds. Nobody else around for the point guard.
Even though that offensive sequence did not yield anything, Delaware had great off the ball movement.
Kirk Lee, a foul on a three-point shot that goes through. Chance for a rare four-point play for Kirk Lee.
Well, Champ is arguing that Kirk Lee jumped forward, and he might have slightly, but my point is, Anthony, don't leave your feet. You have a height advantage on him. You know he has a quick release. Just go straight up and contest the shot. And don't even close to create a foul situation.
Scoreboard showing 15-12, so I believe they're going to review whether it was a three or not. It was a near corner towards us, and if we were able to see it on Hens All Access, I think we'll see that it was a three-point shot, at least from first look. But big difference. You don't want to be the guy that allowed the four-point play. Kirk Lee at only 5'10", great point you make. You have the height advantage, even if you're champ mostly at 6'1", a rare height advantage against somebody, but you don't need to leave your feet. One too many, several too many four-point play opportunities this season against his Delaware defense. And looks like official Jamie Lucky, the longtime vet, showing that it is a three-point shot. How about this referee combo we've got today? Michael Lucky, the son of Jamie, both refereeing this game. And as we see it, looking at the monitor, one, clearly a three, two, clear is back by Anthony Hogan.
Anthony is right on a certain way, jump shot, but not enough, in my mind, to create a fight. You've got to study some tape, understand that the three is going to do that. So you've got to be a little more circumspect, play off of him a little bit more, and then get that high hand contest.
Four-point play complete as Lee makes the free throw, and now Delaware leads by only one. Halfway through the first half, Kirk Lee's 44-3 of the season. Daly deep right side over to Corbett. His first touch offensively, coming off the bench early in this one. Has not played a whole lot of minutes as of late. Daly baseline drive right, cross court to Corbett. Corbett, NBA range three is on the line, but short off the side of the rim. And a pass ahead to Kirk Lee after the defensive rebound by Mojica. Euro step, Kirk Lee leaves it for Mojica, but he stepped out of bounds, and as the ball came to him, he couldn't grab it. So another turnover, that's the eighth of the game for Drexel, and a missed opportunity for the Dragons to round transition.
At times, players that are really quick almost outthink themselves. They get a little too deep. They get caught up in the air. That's what happened to Lee there, trying to find Mojica on the left side, who he typically plays very well with.
A 6-0 run for Drexel over the past minute and some change. It's now 15-14. Delaware still in the lead. They get inside to Carter. Working on Tyshawn Miles. Working hard from left to right. A head fake. Miles is there. Pass out to Hayes. Hayes to Corbett. Corbett, 9 seconds to shoot as he dribbles around the arc. Leans in from the foul line. That's short. And Lee with the defensive rebound. Does not have numbers. Stops. Pops from 18 straight away. Misses ball. His 10th rebound for Ryan Daly, who will settle for the hand.
A terrific job of Darian Bryant and Kasman Hayes to get back on defense. And then Darian confronted Lee, who was forced to take that shot much too early on and not in good position.
Daly puts it on the floor. Pass to Corbett from the wing. Corbett 0-2. Spinning. Looking for his shot off the window, off the mark. Rebound for Drexel once again. That's 0-3 in the last three possessions for Jawarski Corbett. John Moran driving left baseline. Leaves it to his big man Williams in the right hand. A hook shot in the paint is for a lead for Drexel, 16-15. That's an 8-0 run.
Delaware had some confusion defensively there. They were not all playing the correct man, and that allowed the drive on the baseline for Rodney Williams to score inside. Delaware's got to get a little bit tighter defensively after opening the game so solid.
Daly misses an elbow jumper from the right side. Leaves Moran open on the other side for three, and Delaware might want to talk things over. They will. A timeout taken by Mark Inglesby, and we'll take a break with him as the Dragons
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward. It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice. Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward. It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Volunteer with you, Hens. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear for tonight's
offense to the Dragon.
I thought we got out of rhythm, forced some individual action, and then shot very early on. Many times a bad shot, to me, acts like a turnover because of where it rebounds to and then the opportunity for the other team to attack, which Drexel has taken advantage of.
Delaware coming out of the timeout. They go to Carter, who's been somewhat quiet offensively. Passes inside to Mosley. Mosley, baseline pass to Bryant. Corner three, in and out, and a rebound by Major Kennedy. It's 4-on-5 as Muhammad Boss, though, to get back. He fell fighting for the rebound. Now it's 5-on-5 as he joins his teammates. Austin Williams straight away. Over to John Morant, 18 to shoot. Morant made a three, last possession, and now goes inside, missing on the two as it's knocked close to out of bounds. Boss secures the rebound. Mosley with a steal ahead of the pack and lays it up and in with the left hand.
Well, for an experienced player, Morant's pass there was exactly what you see sometimes in the high school level, a soft skip pass up in the air that Mosley read perfectly to intercept it and go down and score. Really great off-the-ball defensive play.
Mosley's 45th steal of the season, second most in the CAA. 15 to shoot for Drexel's Kennedy. Folks went up with the right hand strong, but he'll draw the foul. That'll be the fifth against Delaware.
Delaware
extended minutes starting tonight. He's only played 16 games, averages 7 minutes per game. But he'll find himself at the free throw line. Foul called on Eric Carter, that's his first.
The defensive assignment on Major Kennedy tends to help off a little bit more aggressively than on other players. That's allowed Kennedy to get into the lane a little too easily. If he's not equipped because of his injuries, he should not be able to get in so deep.
Just the 10th free throw of the season for Major Kennedy. Misses the first. He's 3 of 10 on the year. And 4 of 11 as he knocks in the second. 3-point lead for Drexel. 20-17, just under 7 minutes, first half.
Delaware going with their small lineup here. Eric Carter and Jacob Cushing. A nice little stagger screen for Ryan Daly.
Daly, Hayes, and Mosley, the guards. Hayes driving through, and he'll draw the foul. That'll be the fourth foul against the Dragons. And Asmund Hayes, always at his best when he can put that ball on the floor.
It's a great point, especially early on, where it allows you to get the defense off balance. You're attacking from the get-go. Then they begin to cushion you more, give you the opportunity for the rise-up shot, either off the bounce or off the spot.
Four fouls on Drexel. Half of them go to Austin Williams after that one. So he'll sit down with the two fouls. Delaware will inbound right baseline. They go right into Carter on the block, working on Bob. Couple right-hand dribbles, spins towards the baseline and gets one off the glass at a tough angle.
Not only a difficult position, but the fact he had to play right through Boz, well-extended arms. I thought that was one of Eric's more physical finishes.
Ends within one, 20-19, 5 points for Eric Carter. Muhammad Bob has the height advantage on Jacob Cushing and goes up for the shot. He was fouled. I don't know if that was on Cushing or from behind on Ryan Daly. It looks like the foul's going to go against Cushing. That's his first and the sixth on Delaware.
Muhammad Bah, who has not been playing a lot of minutes, must have used about 8 ball fakes on that possession. He did them so quickly that it wasn't affecting Delaware's defense, but just because he was so patient down low, he eventually drew a double team that got the bad angle and allowed him to step through.
Bah, 6'9", 240, tallest player on the team. Does not play a lot of minutes, as you mentioned. 9.9 minutes per game, and he's played half of that average so far. 5 minutes makes the first free throw. Average is just 3 points per game.
They have players from Iceland, from Mali, California, and Maine. They kind of expand the globe, does Drexel.
That's right. Bruiser was using those frequent flyer miles. I don't know if these are Spikers recruits, or I guess Harry
Johnson.
That's
Bamako, Mali, not the capital, and Timbuktu is not the capital either. So.
What is the capital? Can I ask?
Tell you in the next.
All right, we'll keep our listeners tuning in, so it also gave you time to look it up. 22-19 after the free throws from Drexel. Kasvin Hayes with 6:10 left on the first half clock. Daly catches from Mosley. The three is off the mark, and he has not been shooting well from three as of late. As Ryan Daly. Kurt Lee on the run out. Gets stopped at the foul line by Mosley. Back to Bob. Mojica's been on the bench. He comes back onto the floor and passes it to the freshman who stands 5'10", Kurt Lee. Morant inside to Williams. Double team Cubs. Couple dribble. Mosley takes it away. Williams gets it back. 13 to shoot. Cross court pass to Mojica. He's at the foul line. Passes to Lee. Lee gets inside. Dishes to Williams. Williams 6 to shoot. Shot blocked by Carter. Comes down with it with a pass to Kurt Lee over the back of his head. And a missed shot by Lee. Carter tries to get the rebound and is fouled in doing so. A wild play for Drexel, a wild possession, but it ends up with a foul called against the Dragons. So first on Muhammad Buck.
Though Rodney Williams is not a great athlete, he's very explosive. He has quick movements. Did a great job there of securing the ball with his arms and then re-securing it. Muhammad Ba there trying to tip the ball out. It's a great lesson in why, when you're that tall, you should always get position and not go for the tip, created the foul.
Tyshawn Miles will check in. Ba to the bench. Delaware down by three. 5:25 first half here on their home floor where they played so well this season. Carter straight away, just inside the arc. 16 to shoot as he goes back to Mosley. Hayes on the wing, right side. Cross-court pass to Daly. Daly looking inside of Carter. Lobs it in. He had possession or position on John Moran. The height advantage. Good recognition by Daly to dump it in. And the foul called against the Dragons is a team seven.
He's still only a freshman, though he has the experience of probably almost playing 40 minutes every game of a junior. But Ryan Daly is one of the most intelligent players I've had the opportunity to talk about. He's a coach on the floor. He's a coach's son. He really recognizes the subtleties of the game and then knows how to take advantage of it because of his skill level.
A rare breather, and I correct myself, that was a sixth foul for Drexel, so no free throws. Rare breather for Ryan Daly as he'll sit out Bryant into the game. Bryant? Ball fake, baseline, leaves it for Carter, wasn't quite ready and dropped the pass. It rolls out of bounds, but not before it was touched by a Drexel player. It'll stay with Delaware. 5:01 first half clock, 20 seconds to shoot.
Zach Spiker very animated over there, trying to create a turnover for him. Eric Carter very fortunate there because the ball was thrown in a tough position as he was moving to catch it.
Delaware down three. Kaz trying to tie it up with a three from the right wing. He misses, but offensive board by Eric Carter. His third offensive board, and up and in for Eric Carter, who now has seven to lead all score.
Those are great signs of finishing through contact against 6'8", 260-pound Tyshawn Miles. Carter getting better and better almost every possession this evening.
It has been a pleasure to watch Carter grow this season. Williams flips it up on the reverse. That's an athletic move for a 6'7 big man.
And long arms and the ability to spin the ball perfectly.
Hayes inside quickly, misses, shoved his opponent to try to get the offensive rebound. It'll go the other way. That's the seventh on Delaware with the offensive foul. No, it'll be a defensive rebound. Foul on Kasman Hayes. So Drexel will shoot the 1-1. That's the first on Kaz. 24-21 the score. Drexel leads by three.
Kaz had a driving lane to the right. He got confronted and hopscotched into the middle that Euro and tried to finish to the backboard and just threw it up a little hard. At that point, I know he's trying to be aggressive. He's trying to earn some more minutes, but there you just got to stay away from the rebound. It was clearly secured by Drexel.
Good foul, I suppose. I know Hayes wasn't really thinking about it, but it ended up being a good foul as he fouled Tyshawn Miles, not a good free throw shooter, just 10 of 20 on the season. Misses the front end, so Mosley operates for Delaware. Down by three, 24-21, approaching the four-minute mark at 4:06. Baker to Bryant, who stands on top, brings it over to the left side in front of Zach Spiker and the Drexel bench. Eight to shoot now for Darian. Seven as he gets the elbow to Hayes. Hayes with a ball fake and a pull-up J from 18. He misses, but Barnett Harris was fouled, attempting the offensive rebound. So Barnett Harris will shoot the 1-1 when we get back. 24-21, the lead for the Drexel Dragons. 3:53 left in the first half from the Bob Carpenter Center.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Long side of Bill Harmon, Delaware Blue Hens, 4-10 on the season in the CAA. The Dragons of Drexel, 3-11 in the conference. Two bottom teams in the standings, but these two teams go way back. This is the 156th meeting all time between these squads used to battle it out in the American East. Right now, Drexel leads by 3, 24-21, with a chance to cut in for Barnett Harris, who will shoot the 1-on-1. Barnett Harris doesn't get a whole lot of trips to the line, but when he does, he shoots the team's second-best percentage at 74.
Barnett's got a beautiful stroke. I've watched him in practice from the three-point line as well. He was a terrific long-range shooter in high school and then in his prep school year. But Barnett's hustle makes him so difficult to block out.
Harris showing off that form from the free throw line, makes the first. I remember back to a shoot-around I went to when we were up at Yale, and watching this guy knock down 5, 6, 7, probably more threes in a row, just kind of messing around. But he does have a good-looking shot and showing off at the free throw line, making them both, and Delaware back with a point.
I just love the way he plays. He's so interesting and passionate, giving a lot of body English, looking like a golfer there on that last free throw that went in.
Kirk Lee to Rodney Williams as Drexel gets it back offensively. Double team comes, Mosley nearly knocks it away. Over to Kennedy, 15 to shoot for Drexel. Kirk Lee wearing the number 30 jersey without the name on the back. He forgot his number one jersey as Delaware, or as Drexel came down the road to Delaware. 5 to shoot for Mojica. Bryant, good defense. Mojica over Bryant, and it's strong. The rebound, Anthony Mosley. He wants to run. Gets to the foul line and will bring it back out with 25 to shoot.
Terrific on the ball. Contest high hand defense by Darian Bryant on that last defensive possession.
17 to shoot now as Mosley has it. Pass to Daly, who has the height advantage on Kirk Lee. Knows it. Passes out to Mosley, though, and it's wide for Champ, who was cutting to the spot that Daly threw it to, and a turnover for Delaware. Their third. Drexel has 9 turnovers so far.
Ryan Daly, recognizing he had the much shorter Kirk Lee on him, tried to back him down, but Lee held his ground, and then Ryan got a little off balance and tried to throw a moving pass to the cutter that was unsuccessful.
Under 3 minutes to play. Lee, good first step. Double team comes. Harris bumped him, though, along the baseline. Michael Lucky with the call, and that'll be the 8th foul against Delaware, so free throw, at least one free throw coming up for Kirk Lee. The 1-on-1, a 68% free throw shoot.
Sometimes the quickness just overpowers you. Barnett Harris in pretty good position. It was just that last little move by Kirk Lee, who was trying to dribble on the baseline, that Barnett moved his right knee into him. But pretty good help defense for the most part by Delaware here this evening on the baseline drives, and also some really aggressive double teams from different angles on Rodney Williams.
He's got 7 coming off the bench. Leads Drexel. Misses the second free throw. Made the first. 25-23. This was the score up in Philadelphia. The exact score up in Philly before Drexel went on a 20-3 run. I don't see that happening tonight. It doesn't feel like that type of evening for Delaware. But they've got the basketball and a chance to tie or take the lead. Bryant with the float shot. Assist Anthony Mosley, and we are not at 25.
I love it when players recognize a full deny and then a back door, and the defense does not open up. They keep their head turned. You deliver a pass, as Mosley did, to a cutting Darian Bryant.
Williams unties the score with a baseline jumper left side. 27-25 the count.
Though Williams is not Marvin King Davis, who had really expanded his game into that mid-range, has a nice shot with a very high release that he can get off from 15 feet and in.
Carter backing down. Tyshawn Miles gets it over to Ryan Daly. Under 2 minutes to play first half. Pinkert passes back to Mosley. He wasn't looking. Darian Bryant saves it from going behind backcourt. 8 to shoot, though. Pull up, Jay. Bryant around and out, and a rebound to Rodney Williams. Ahead of the pack is Miles. He can't control the pass. It hits his hands out of bounds and back to Delaware. Double digits for turnovers for the Drexel Dragons.
Zach Spiker congratulating his team because he wants to get some action in the free flow form, especially transitioning from defense to offense. But throwing the ball ahead to Tyshawn Miles with a defender around him, to me, would never yield a good benefit.
Got to know your receiver. Tyshawn Miles, not a guy that's going to grab that in traffic with his big frame. 23 to shoot for Delaware as they get in their offense. 90 seconds left in the first half. Crossover Mosley, corner three, Pinkert, it's good, and Delaware is back on top.
Anthony Mosley creating just enough space by drawing the help off of Devon Pinkert, who loves that left corner. Very quick release with high arc.
Pinkert went 0 of 6 from the field the first time these two teams met. Makes a three there. Lee with an answer. Gets Drexel back up by 2, 30 to 28.
What impresses me about Kirk Lee at only 5'10", he knows when he has just the right amount of space to get the shot up. Anthony Mosley's got to jam him a little bit closer.
Lee, the first player in double figures, he's got 10, came off the bench tonight. Freshman is the team's second leading scorer on the season. Mosley gets in deep, sends it back out to Daly. Daly, a couple of dribbles and a pass back to Champ. 10 to shoot as no one stops Mosley from getting to the rim, and he finishes with a left hand.
Rodney Williams picked his own defender, Kirk Lee, which allowed Mosley to work again, surprisingly, into the lane with his left hand and score.
Mosley had a CAA high 18 points against Drexel back in January. Lee drives in, Kennedy to the foul line, floats one up with the right hand, misses, another rebound for Ryan Daly. 22 seconds left in the first half, and it's tied at 30, shot clock unplugged.
A wild shot there by Major Kennedy. Had no chance because he had not established a two-foot shot or any type of balance.
10 seconds for Daly, deep right side. It's at 8 to Mosley straight away. 6 to shoot for Mosley. He drives off the window, and with 2 seconds remaining, Delaware will take a lead into the locker room as the clock eventually expires after Anthony Mosley gets his 8 point of the first half.
That was great recognition by Anthony Mosley, knowing he had the slower Major Kennedy on him. Major Kennedy allowed him to get to his left hand again. Shoots that little floater off the backboard, but he's not out of control as some other times. I thought it was just a great recognition by Mosley in completing the play through some contact.
Well, it is halftime, but last time we were here at the Bob Carpenter Center and we said it was halftime, it was not halftime at all. There was a presentation on the floor, and after 4 or 5 minutes, the game continued, and I was a little nervous to send it to Josh Durr because the officials were looking at the monitors, but I think we're clear. I think we're okay to go and take a timeout, so that's what we're going to do. 32-30 at the break. Delaware leads it by 2. We'll take a timeout when we come back. It's the Blue Hens Halftime Report presented by the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers Local 313. Josh Durr back in the studio. He'll have scores from around the CAA and the world of college hoops. Back in a moment on the Blue Hens Sports.
Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's 5.
Nice.
Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart. Moving forward.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Hi guys, today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there's only one Special Edition? Because actually there's 5.
Nice.
Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions. Hi, guys. Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice.
Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Hi, guys. Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice.
Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions. Hi, guys. Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice.
Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Hi, guys. Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice.
Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
We'll be right back.
Hi, guys. Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice.
Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Hi, guys. Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice.
Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions. Hi, guys. Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice.
Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Hi, guys. Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there was only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice.
Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions. Hi, guys. Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your
first a little bit better job of confronting the three-point shooters, and I think our double teams have worked fairly well on Rodney Williams. He's just had an answer for us a couple times. We've got to be more consistent in our angles on that. But overall, I think Delaware's done a pretty good job of handling the tempo. I think that's the most important thing with Drexel. You do not want to let them get in a free-flow situation. Pretty good defense on Sammy Mojica and Austin Williams, a player that I think needs to feed off of Rodney Williams. Done an excellent job on him. He has one rebound and already two fouls. He did have two early blocks, but only one field goal attempt. So pretty good interior defense by that four-man of Delaware, whoever it might be in the rotation.
And right now it's Jacob Cushing. His starters come back on the floor for Delaware. Cushing, Bryant, Daly, Carter, and Mosley to start things off for Delaware. They'll defend first. Drexel switching up the starting lineup as Kirk Lee will enter, joining Rodney and Austin Williams, John Moran, and Sammy Mojica. Drexel will go left to right as we look at it across from the Delaware bench, and we're underway with the score 32-30. Delaware Lee, Drexel with the rock to start the second half.
This is a horn set up at the three-point line. Normally run to get Rodney Williams the ball down low.
Rodney Williams with the basketball. Bounce pass out of a double team. Moran thought about a three and said goes back to Williams. Defended by Eric Carter. Gets into the paint. Head fake. Reverse. Missing. Austin Williams can't snare the rebound. And Anthony Mosley can. He brings the ball up the floor for Delaware. Speeding towards the basket. And the wave off the shot. Basket didn't fall anyway. But Eric Carter with the illegal screen inside the paint. Picks up the first for Delaware. The second on Carter.
Carter's got to realize that Mosley has an advantage. He's driving the ball. Steer clear, space a little bit, get yourself in position for an offensive rebound, because Mosley had gotten deep and I think would have scored again.
32-30, Delaware's lead. Second possession of the second half is Moran. Goes to Williams, lob up top for Williams, jumps to get it, over Cushing, lands and puts it up with the right hand. First bucket of the second half, and we're tied at 32.
Typically when Drexel goes high and low, Austin Williams is the passer. That time he's the recipient of a great lob find by Rodney Williams.
Darian Bryant with the basketball over to Daly. Daly to Mosley, the team's leading scorer in the first 20 minutes. Daly gets Rodney Williams off his feet to the foul line. Jump shot no good. And Ryan Daly, 3 of 9 now from the field. Kirk Lee on the other end. Crossover, freshman on freshman matchup, and Kirk Lee gets it high above Ryan Daly and in. 12 points for Lee.
Ryan Daly's got to understand he's got to send Kirk Lee, a much shorter player, to his weak hand in that situation. Do not go with a little head and shoulders fake.
Kick ball as it goes out of bounds. Mosley trying to enter it into Eric Carter. First 4 points of the second half have gone to Drexel. Delaware will inbound left baseline. Anthony Mosley will trigger it in. They throw it into Daly. Daly on the wing left side. Guarded by Williams. On top to Bryant. Bryant dribbling in close. Some hesitation moves. Gets past Williams. And the reverse. Up and in for Darian Bryant.
We talk so often, Darian Bryant having a great feel for how to score. That time he used the rim going to the reverse side as a shot block protector against the big man Williams.
Pass from Williams to Williams. Hits the side of the backboard as they were trying to lob it inside to the big man. Another turnover for Drexel. Cushing open on the other side. And Delaware is back in the lead.
A horrible breakdown defensively. Mojica left Jacob Cushing. Austin Williams very slow to get out to a man who they know can shoot the three. And a really confident stroke there by Jacob Cushing.
Cushing shooting so well from beyond the arc as of late. He's made 6 of his last 10 from three. Williams found inside, open on the right block. A breakdown defensively for Delaware. And the Hens are up 37-36 after that basket from the Dragon.
Zach Spiker at halftime clearly wanted to get Austin Williams involved, which will ultimately help free up Rodney Williams.
Inside to Carter. He had a great first half. Banging against Austin Williams, turns to his left, and Williams gets his third block. He passes it to Mojica, though. Deflected out of bounds off the hands of Mojica, who nearly had a triple-double against Delaware in the first meeting. Really has been a non-factor so far in this one.
Different defenders on Mojica, but Darian Bryant really drawing the key assignment. Has done a great job of confronting him every time he drives.
Cushing into traffic. Williams gets the block. But a foul's going to be called on the other Williams, Rodney. So that will be a foul against the Dragons. It'll send Jacob Cushing to the free throw line, where he's not had a whole lot of trips. 4 of 8 on the season. But boy, have we seen this young man grow late in his freshman campaign.
And the young man from Naperville, his mom here, Laura.
That's right.
Coming all the way in for a long weekend. Great support of her son. Got a chance to speak to her before the game. really impressed with Jacob not relying on his three-point shooting, driving the ball against a big, tough, physical front line and willing to take a hit.
Mentioned Jacob Cushing, six of his last 10 from three have gone through. That's over the last four games. Remember, he was one of 17 to start this season from three. He was frustrating, but he stayed with it. He's a good shooter, although he does miss both free throws there. Somehow gets his own rebound as it went through two Drexel defenders' hands. So Cushing has it back in front of the Delaware bench. Ends up 37-36. They go inside to Carter, turns and faces, cross-court pass to Bryant. Bryant to the foul line. Float shot is good. The runner puts Delaware up by three.
Well, a wonderful drive by I'm only laughing, Darian Bryant, because Moran was right there for a charge, and I'm just amazed that it wasn't called.
Williams with the basketball left wing to Rodney Williams, who hands it off to Kurt Lee. Kurt Lee gets himself to the foul line. Float shot with the left hand. Soft touch doesn't roll in, and a rebound goes to Ryan Daly, who's one away from double figures in that category.
One of the reasons Ryan Daly is such a good rebounder, he is relentless in his attack at both ends of the glass.
Mosley, a pass to Bryant, who's played so well today. 5 of 7 from the field, double figures again for Bryant. And that's now 6 of the last 7 for Darian. Mosley in too deep, shot blocked, and a rebound by Mojica for Drexel. 16-14, second half. Hens lead 39-36.
Mosley got caught a little deep without any activity where he could dribble the ball, and two big shot blockers, the Williams brothers, there to confront him.
Williams on the wing. 15 to shoot. Couple of pass fakes. It goes to Austin. Ronnie Williams, mid-right block to Austin Williams, and he scores again. And you're right, Zach Spiker wanting to get Austin Williams involved. He's got 6 points all in the second half.
And he can be a matchup issue because of his size, and his movements are quite good, and he presents a big post-up opportunity. Rodney Williams, his teammate, doing a good
inside
job of finding.
Inside to Bryant, and it was Mosley who found him. 41-38, Delaware lead.
Great activity off the ball by Darian Bryant, reading screens really well that time. A great weak side cut. Mosley with a proper delivered pass.
Moran, not a properly delivered pass. Is that one stolen away on the inside by Carter? His second steal. Delaware in transition. Corner three, Cushing. Short from the wing, and a rebound by Eric Carter found to be called against Drexel, and that'll send us to a timeout with Delaware. The momentum on their side, on their home floor. 41-38, the count with 15-13 to play here in New Orleans.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Bryant now in double figures for 6 of the last 7 contests. He's 6 of 8 from the field, 12 points for the redshirt sophomore transfer from George Washington.
And you said it, a redshirt sophomore, young. He really hasn't played a whole lot, but as his minutes build, you can just see the activity level of his game. He's got a lot of versatility to it, as we've talked about, but what I love is his leadership skills growing. That time he passed up a three-point shot himself to deliver the ball to Jacob Cushing in the deep corner, a true freshman, and after the miss, it wasn't like, hey, come on, make the shot. It was like a hand slap. Hey, don't worry about it. I'll get it to you again, and you keep shooting it. So I really like those skills that Darian Bryant has brought to the team.
Coming back from break, Delaware leads 41-38 with the basketball. Pinkard in, Harris in, joining Daly, Bryant, and Mosley on the floor. Harris, a very good passing big man, sends it back out to Mosley, sets the screen. Harris playing with three fouls. Mosley cross court to Pinkert. Pinkert corner to Bryant. Bryant dribble drive, crossover on Moran, goes up over Moran, and a whistle there to call an offensive foul on Darian Bryant. A little too aggressive on the tape.
Moran did a nice job there. I mentioned earlier where I thought he might have had an opportunity for a charge draw. He did a good job of moving his feet and not allowing Darian Bryant to get to his shoulder. He made him take him on in the torso. So that was just good, what I call individual defense by staying in front, Moran versus Bryant.
Second foul on Delaware, first on Bryant. Drexel bring the ball up the floor, corner Mojica. Mojica, a dribble drive, gets inside the paint, rejected and sent away by Darian Bryant. Hens in transition, contact, offensive foul. The shot was missed by Ryan Daly, but they'll call an offensive charge anyway against the freshman. Carpenter Center faithful on their feet. They didn't like that call, and I think they have an argument.
A tough call against Ryan Daly. Scott, he may have gotten just a little deep in his attack. If you see a what I call a potential charge drawer there in front of you, just pull up and shoot that mid-range shot. Don't force, over-force your action so deep.
We're taking a look at it. We have a replay monitor that we can see, but it looked like Moran might have beat him to the spot, but possibly moving. It was a bang-bang call, and it goes against Delaware. Drexel trailing by three with the basketball. Pass stolen away by Daly. Daly, another chance in transition. This time all the way to the rim. Contact plus one. Ryan Daly, a steal, a foul, and a bucket.
The difference that time was that Ryan Daly versus Moran, Ryan was not as out of control. He was playing at a better pace, had a different angle to the basket that Moran could not get right in front of him. So a good recognition offensively by Ryan Daly of how he's being played in transition.
Daly has made 33 of his last 35, 33 of 36 now after he misses that one flat on the free throw.
He talked to us earlier in the season about getting up on his toes a little bit more, utilizing his legs. That time he did not.
Hens can't complete the three-point play. Moran fadeaway three, missing, rebounded by Bob. Nobody on the interior for Delaware to grab that defensive board, and the Hens lead back to three.
Drexel rebounds a high percentage of their misses. You've got to make sure you get a body on them and also hold the block out long enough.
43-40. Is the count. Delaware on top. Mosley to Bryant, who's been stellar. 12 points on 6 of 8 shooting. Pinker, the only 3 for Delaware, has it on the wing, flips it to Anthony Mosley. Foul line jumper right side. He's fouled with 7 to shoot, and Anthony will go to the stripe for 2.
Anthony, who has been driving the ball most recently, did a good job there of creating some space with a little step back and utilizing his quickness. Kirk Lee then tried to close him out and did tap him on the elbow.
Lee called for the first foul, or his first foul, fourth on Drexel this half. Mosley at the stripe for 2, 77%, team's best free throw percentage this season. Misses that one, Delaware struggling a bit from the free throw line. 0-4 now this half, 3-8 throughout this game thus far.
Concentration, consistent mechanics, the proper trajectory, usually the keys to good free throw shooting.
Mosley at 18 points against Drexel up in Philly. CAA high and a rare double miss for Anthony Mosley. Hens 0-5 from the stripe. In this second half, they lead 43-40 as Kirk Lee, the freshman, goes inside to Ba. Back out to Lee. The lefty freshman, 5'10", throws it back to Ba. Two-man game, 15 to shoot. Working on Harris, who has 3 fouls. Spins baseline. Harris is there. Frustrating Ba. Ba sends it back out to Lee. Lee on the dribble drive, baseline right. His pass deflected and stolen away by Darian Bryant. Hens have numbers. Daly back to Bryant. Trailing was Moran. He got back to the steal. Ball is loose. Harris on the floor. Knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Drexel. It was Barnett Harris, who never let the play. Got back and kept it in Delaware possession.
Drexel a little unlucky. A great job by John Moran, the graduate, getting back on defense and then harassing and almost intercepting it. Barnett, though, again, very quick, and his long arms are so active, got down there and created the turnover.
Daly inside off the inbound. No one could stay in front. And Ryan Daly in double figures for the 18th time in his last 20 games.
Daly's very good along the baseline because he utilizes a shot fake, gets the right angle. Lee
stop and pop from downtown. A quick shot, and Kirk Lee is leading Drexel. He's got 15 of their 43, a two-point lead for Delaware as Bryant brings it to the right side. Pinker with a three, can't answer, around and out, and Drexel a chance to tie or retake the lead. Ahead to Moran. Moran, bounce pass is stolen away by Pinker. Here comes the Hens. Bryant across half court. No one stops the ball, and Darian can't finish at the rim. Pinker battling for the rebound. Ball knocked loose. Daly ends up with it. Push shot from 3 feet is good for Ryan Daly, and a timeout taken by the Drexel Dragons with 12:06 remaining in the second half. We'll take a break with Zach Spiker. Hens up 47-43.
Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there's only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice. Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Welcome back to the Bob Carpenter Center. I'm Scott Kaplan alongside Bill Harmon. Of course, this broadcast brought to you by Star Health at the University of Delaware. Star Health, a new direction in healthcare. Also, remind our listeners, nothing great was built on an empty stomach. Dash It now offers all new breakfast sandwiches on a warm, buttery croissant roll. Grab a 16-ounce Dash It coffee and a breakfast sandwich for only $3.50. Delaware leads 47-43, a timeout taken just a moment ago by Zach Spiker. We will have another media timeout at the under 12, 12:06 right now, but this is the most up and down play we've seen in a long time.
Both teams have taken the ball into some bad places, especially Drexel, who then has tried to pass out of these horrific spots, and that's one of the reasons they have 16 turnovers. Only 8 in the first game, already doubled that. Part of it's Delaware's defense, and I also wanted to comment that one of the really interesting things about Ryan Daly's game is he can play so aggressively without doing a lot of fouling.
He's got a double-double to his Ryan Daly. Fourth double-double of the season. Earlier this year became the first freshman with back-to-back double-doubles since Greg Smith did it back in 1994. Delaware defending in a zone, 2-3, as they come out of the timeout with a new look for Drexel. 8 to shoot. Mojica, 3 from the left wing, is short. Line drive shot off the front of the rim. Kasman Hayes had it, lost it. Lee picks it up. Now Ba with it. Back over to the freshman Lee, who will settle.
Lee's quickness there was the determinant of getting that loose ball. Delaware's done a good job at times with their zone. Be a little careful out the weak side, though.
Kennedy open for a three, and Major Kennedy just his third triple of the season, but he gets his team back within a point.
The ball goes into the middle, then reversed out immediately. That's what I was a little worried about there from Delaware. High percentage of scores per possession by Drexel versus zone.
Hayes throws it right to the Delaware bench. Miscommunication between he and Daly. The turnover just a seventh for the Hens. It'll send us to another timeout. 11:06 remaining, and a close one here in Newark. Delaware leads 47-46.
Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there's only one Special Edition? Because actually there's five.
Nice. Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
Can I get a pick two? It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. start moving forward.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for
great... Here we are, Delaware, close one. What else would you expect between these two long-time rivals? 79 and 76, Delaware leads all time against Drexel. 47-46 is the score. Delaware came out the last time out in a zone defensively, and here's where Kerry Johnson playing, who's out with the flu for Drexel, would help the Dragons.
Johnson is an excellent spot-up shooter. He's got a very quick release. Drexel scores almost a point per possession versus zone, so I don't expect Delaware to stay in it long, and they've already gone back to man.
Back to man here, Pinkard guarding Austin Williams on the left block. Does a good job of forcing him out, 14 to shoot. The screen set for Lee, hedging on the screen is Carter. Lee, behind the back dribble, and pass to Mojica. He slams into Eric Carter, who takes a charge, going the other way.
Boy, I love it when big men get positioned perfectly, stay in a guarding position and take a charge. Eric Carter recognizing Mojica, driving hard with his right hand, which he loves to do. Perfect position.
Carter's been very solid in this contest for Delaware. Hens lead it by one. Drexel last led when it was 34-32 about 8 minutes ago. Delaware's led since. Daly with the basketball. Inside to Carter. Has good position. Kick out. Hayes a three over the defender is no good. Hayes, 25% three-point shooter on the season, and he is 0-4 from the field tonight. Drexel a chance to retake the lead. Mojica over to Kennedy. Lee has been tough. Has a quick first step with the basketball on the wing right side. Kennedy made a three. Gives it back to Lee. Lee to the foul line, dribbling with that left hand. Mojica over to Lee. 11 to shoot, 10 minutes to play. Inside to Ba. Left block. Fakes the pass to Kennedy. Keeps it himself. 5 seconds now. The running hook is strong. Rebounded by Austin Williams, keeping it alive for Drexel. Now Lee straight away. Three is good, and Drexel leads it 49-47.
Lee really senses when the defense has sloughed off of him a little bit and then allows him to step into that long-range shot. Good activity on the weak side by Williams to secure that offensive rebound.
Lee's fourth three of the evening as Pinkard passed to Cushing, knocked out of bounds by Drexel. Kirk Lee, over 400 points now on the season. Only 16 freshmen in the nation have gotten to that mark. Malik Monk the most. Markel Fultz, a former player that played at DeMatha for our assistant coach Corey McCray, leading freshman scorers in the nation. But Kirk Lee, top 20 scorer in the country when it comes to rookie. Daly, not a bad look. Rookie himself off the window, too strong, and Carter can't control. Last touch by Austin Williams. It'll stay with Delaware. 9 to shoot, though, as no one had possession on the rebound, and Daly's shot did not touch the rim.
Eric Carter doing a good job there with his positioning and not fouling, getting over the back of Austin Williams. Daly a little out of control there with that bank shot on the left side.
Daly 6 of 13 from the field. Mosey will throw it in to Daly. Head fakes on a three, drives to the foul line, pumps, looks for Cushing, can't get it to him. 4 to shoot, shoots over defender, and an out tipped around, and a rebound for Kurt Lee. 2-point lead. Lee trying to extend that high off the window and a miss, but a foul is going to be called as it looked like Bob might have been nudged by Eric Carter going that offensive board.
And that was a good foul by Aaron Carter because Ba had sealed off Carter and the defender on Lee as he drove down the left side. Ba would have just dropped that ball in on a tip-in.
That's the third on Carter, though, and Delaware playing without Sky Johnson. We mentioned Kerry Johnson for Drexel out with the flu. Sky Johnson, same case for Delaware. He's unavailable, so short bench for the front court of Delaware. As Kennedy brings it left to right, Mojica inside to Williams. Williams has some muscle advantage on Jacob Cushing. Kick out to Lee. Kennedy working the ball around the perimeter. Mojica three around and out. Cushing, what a box out on the bigger Austin Williams for a defensive board. Mosley across the lane, flips it up a miss, but he draws the foul. A nice shot by Mosley. Hopscotching his way past a couple defenders to the rim.
Anthony was forced away from his left hand, which doesn't happen often because he's so clever at finding the right angle and the right timing. It goes to the weak side and draws the foul. Bailed out by Drexel's big man, who really should have just been affecting the shot there. But that quickness of Anthony Mosley and his physicality, a really tough combination to deal with.
First free throw of the half made for Delaware. They were 0-5 before that make for Mosley. That's a third foul for Austin Williams. Didn't play a whole lot in that first half because of the two fouls. Doesn't pick up his third here until 8:38 remaining. High score 49-all as Mosley knocks them both. Mosley with 10 points and the entire backcourt for Delaware all in double figures. 12 for Daly and Bryant, 10 for Chan. Drexel looking inside to one of the Williams. It's Austin. Can't get it to him. Instead, they go outside to Lee. Strong and a rebound by Carter. Quick outlet to Mosley. Mosley bounce pass. Daly. Daly inside. Uses the left in transition.
Great assist there by Anthony Mosley. He might come up a little lame there. He may have turned his ankle slightly on the drop-off pass.
Staying in there and defending, but is limping. Good eye, Bill. We'll see how long Mosley can stay in. A good floor general. As a junior from Sanford, he's kind of looking over at Coach Inglesby. He might need a blow. They will get the media timeout at the next whistle. Pass is stolen away by Carter. He flips it to Mosley. Mosley ahead to Cushing. Cushing has Kennedy to beat at the rim. Ball knocked out of bounds, and that'll be the break that Mosley needs to get that ankle worked on by Paul Lowry and the training staff. 51-49, Delaware back in control. This one's gone back and forth 10 times and still 7:46 to play. We'll take a break from the Bob Carpenter Center in Newark.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Basketball on 94.7 WBSD.
Here in Newark, I'm Scott Klaskin alongside Bill Harmon. 7:46 remaining in Delaware leads 51-49. Lead has changed hands 10 times in this contest. We tried to look into the huddle during the break. Didn't get a good angle, but Anthony Mosley now as we break huddle. Back on the floor. It did look like he hurt his ankle on the previous play, but he is going to come out and he'll inbound on the left baseline with 26 to shoot into Jacob Cushing. Daly gets it on top. His defender falls. Passes to Cushing. Bobbled the pass. If he caught it cleanly, would have had an open look at a three. Goes inside to Carter. Carter's been quiet this half. Dumps it to Daly. Daly, the float shot is good. And those two are so connected, Daly and Carter, whether it's Carter feeding Daly or Daly feeding Eric Carter. After the bucket by Daly, he and Austin Williams got tangled and a stoppage. I don't think a foul was called. I think
there was
a
no foul called. I think it was just incidental contact as Daly was running back. What a nice drop-off pass by Eric Carter. At the timeout you and I were talking, Carter not attacking as much as we might like. I think he's been almost a little too unselfish in there, kicking the ball out, especially after he repositioned himself. But that time, good recognition that Daly had lost his defender, a drop-off pass, and that nice little floater along the baseline.
Daly's got 16 to lead Delaware. Lee's got 18 to lead the Dragons. Delaware leads in this one 53-49, and another turnover as Lee's passed too wide for Kennedy. He tried to keep it in bounds, but could not along the sideline. 19 turnovers for Drexel, and somehow Delaware only leads by four.
That's a scary total for a college team in a low possession close game.
Bryant with the basketball, guarded by Mojica. A lot of basketball left as Bryant drives. Cross-court pass to Cushing, but a foul is going to be called on Bryant, who left his feet and crashed into a Drexel defender.
Once you ascertain that that's something Drexel does, and you know they've been doing it all season, you've got to adjust. You just cannot get out of control, jump stop more often, or don't get so deep or throw these passes from tough angles. Drexel clearly looking to do that to Delaware.
Second foul on Bryant, both on the offensive side. Kennedy splits a double team inside to Williams, who gets the flush with two hands.
You come to double team, you've got to make sure your angles are proper. The ball's going to be sent away from the basket. Kennedy doing a great job there of splitting, and then a great drop-off pass to Rodney Williams.
Two-point lead for Delaware, 53-51. Mosley on the left wing to Daly. Eyes up with three and hits his first of the night. A timeout taken by Delaware will stay right here. How about Ryan Daly, who was 0-3 from three, making only 7 of his last 33 in the past 7 games. But boy, oh boy, does he pick his right spots to hit these big shots time and time again, especially recently the game-tying shot against Elon, the game-tying shot against James Madison, and this one now to give Delaware a 5-point advantage.
He does have impeccable timing. What he did there so well, though, is that he read the screen. It was a pin-down screen, but in the middle of the court, his defender sunk underneath. He immediately rolled and kind of curled just enough to be in the proper position and rose up. And I thought he used his legs a little bit better there, Scott. He got a little bit more extension with his elbow, a beautifully released shot. But it starts with Ryan understanding how the defense is playing him, reading and adjusting.
Daly's got 19 to lead all scorers now. And the Hens have a 5-point lead. They've led by as many as 7 points that coming in the first half of basketball. Kennedy on the right side after the timeout by Delaware. Hens will have 1 timeout remaining, 3 timeouts left for Drexel. Austin Williams at the point to Kennedy. 12 to shoot. Pushing Hedges on the screen. Lee has had the hot hand inside to Austin Williams. He's got the height and the weight advantage on Cushing. Goes for the runner, left hand, no good. Rebound by Cushing. Mosley ahead of the pack, he'll wait for his teammate.
The understanding by Jacob Cushing on his low post defense was superb there. Forced Austin Williams to go to his left hand. Excellent job then of blocking him out and securing the rebound.
Daly to the foul line, and a foul's going to be called against Rodney Williams, who's trying to shove his way past the screen set by Eric Carter. That's the 7th foul on the Dragons. Daly had the basketball in his hands, but I believe the free throw shooter will be Carter because that's who was pushed out away on the screen. A kind of break for Drexel. Certainly Daly a better free throw shooter than Eric Carter.
Second time Rodney Williams has been rubbed off on the screen read by Daly. No choice there but to fight through it. And just Ryan Daly taking advantage of the fact that Rodney Williams not as used to playing out on the perimeter in those cases, especially with a more mobile player like Ryan Daly.
Front end of the 1-on-1 for Eric Carter. Delaware continues to struggle from the line. 2 of 8 after that front end miss by Carter. 56-51. The lead for Delaware. Bryant, Carter, Pinkard, Daly, and Mosley on the floor. Lee gets in deep. Wide open is Moran for 3. Too strong. Rebound by Carter. His head up the floor, but passes to his teammate Anthony Mosley, who will walk it up. Drexel has made just 1 out of their last 6. In the meantime, Delaware has made each of their last 3 shots on offense. 5:32 to play, and Bryant goes inside to Carter. 0-1 this half. 3 of 6 for the game. Carter with the float shot around a defender and a miss, and Kurt Lee will bring it up. He's in a hurry. 27 to shoot. He'll bring it back down and wait for some teammates, but not long. Inside to Ronnie Williams. Double team comes. He spins baseline. He's fouled and has enough on the shot to get it up and in. Carter and Pinkard were both there, and Ronnie Williams, very aware of where the double team was coming, got the shot off and can finish a 3-point play.
The recognition of the angle of the double team, Rodney Williams immediately spinning baseline, beating the double team before it could arrive. Got caught on the top side as well, and then no chance other than to foul Rodney Williams, who then forced it in. So it was really good offense by Rodney Williams down on the low block.
The first free throw of the half for Drexel goes through, and it is a 2-point lead for Delaware, 56-54. Pinkard with the basketball, corner, Bryant saw an opening, rises to the rim, too strong, a foul is going to be called against Drexel's Austin Williams, and that's the 4th on the junior from Richmond.
If I'm not mistaken there, I caught a scene, but I think Drexel may have switched after that score to a zone. They caught one of the bottom defenders rising up, and then Darian Bryant attacks along the baseline, a back door against zone, a great concept, and a really tough finish. Didn't get it, but I just loved his physicality.
Bryant misses another free throw for Delaware. Tough outing for the Hens, who are 5 of 13 from the stripe in this close basketball game. That can really hurt you. Bryant corrects his mistake, makes the second one, ends up by 3.
Delaware themselves and man-to-man have been doing a pretty good job of keeping Lee from scoring, but he's been a pretty good distributor, though they haven't been able to capitalize on his good passing.
At least as of late, Lee has 18 points total. Inside to Williams, touch pass to Moran. He's missed a couple, so now he wants to drive. Flips it to Williams. Williams on the reverse is fouled with 4:39 to play. Williams back to the stripe.
Moran very intelligently there as he got in, realized he'd probably have no chance to score himself, so he's a driver there to pass. Delaware's got to understand that and make sure that Rodney Williams' attack angle has got to be confronted by a defender. That time Delaware slow to rotate, Moran with a great attack, and then a drop ball pass.
Oh, 23 minutes for John Moran, who averages 12 minutes per game. Kerry Johnson not available tonight. Williams misses the first free throw. Moran, interesting story, graduate student, graduated University of Richmond, appeared in 19 games in 4 years for the Spiders, scored 21 points, and now 71 points this season, playing big-time minutes for the Dragons down the stretch. Williams makes the second free throw, and it's 57-55, 4:37 to go, and a close one at the Bob Carpenter Center. Daly with the basketball, guarded by Rodney Williams, bringing him away from the hoop. Mosley on the wing, as Drexel back in that man-to-man. Carter will catch it on the left side. 12 to shoot as they go to Daly. Daly gets a screen from Eric Carter. 9 to shoot for Daly. Austin Williams in defense. Long range three for Ryan Daly. Hits the front rim and back to the Dragons it goes.
The length of Williams that time made Ryan Daly change the arc on the shot.
Daly just 1 of 5 from three. Austin Williams, number 5, with it, top of the key. Over to Mojica, who's been quiet. Ronnie Williams with the basketball. Double team comes, passes out of it. Moran to Lee. Good defense by Mosley. As they work it back around, right to left. Mojica dribbling a lot with 7. Now 6 seconds left. Moran, deep left side with 4. Got to force one up with 2. And a push off before the shot goes against the Drexel Dragons. That'll bring us to our final timeout. 3:44 to play in a close one. Delaware leads 57-55.
Today we're here to talk about the Chevy Silverado Special Edition.
Awesome.
What's your first impression?
It looks sick.
This is one gorgeous truck.
Oh, did I say there's only one special edition? Because actually there's 5.
Nice. Strength and style.
Which one's your favorite?
Come home with me.
Introducing the Chevy Silverado Special Editions.
Let me get a big pick two. Can I get a big pick two?
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Hi, guys.
Matter the record for these two teams, this game sure does mean a whole lot, and there's two teams out there playing tough like it does mean something. Delaware up by 2 with the basketball. They've got to find a way to score offensively. It's been 3 minutes and 2 seconds since they've hit a shot.
Both teams have played really hard. Both teams have exerted a lot of energy kind of hanging in there with one another. I think the team that can get to the foul line and convert here in the last 3:43 and take a little bit better care of the ball. Certainly Drexel been plagued with massive turnovers, 20 thus far.
Hens with the basketball. Delaware with 19 to shoot, 3:30 to play, and they'll work the ball around the arc. Mosley with it now. Screen comes to the foul line. Carter sets it. Mosley inside. Strong take for Champ. And Delaware back up 4.
We talk about it so often, but the ability of Anthony Mosley to get exactly where he wants down the lane on the left side.
Moran from the corner, pass out, Williams, deep 2, short rebound, Austin Williams on the offensive glass, Ronnie Williams left alone, and he leans in for 1, Ryan Daly was just trying to get out of his way, but the contact is drawn, and a 3-point play opportunity.
That's just one of those unfortunate things where you're in the almost the right place at the wrong time, and Daly trying to make himself tall and thin there and not affect the shot, but somehow there was some body contact. That's just an unlucky play, because Daly was definitely not trying to affect the play.
It's the second foul on Daly, the eighth on Delaware. Dragons have nine fouls, so Delaware will be in the double bonus next time the whistle goes against the Dragons. Williams makes the free throw. And a one-point game, 59-58. Score's been tied five times tonight. Lead has changed hands 10 times, but Drexel hasn't led since the first half of basketball. Mosley gets to the foul line. He scored on the last possession. Kick out to Cushing. Cushing driving baseline. Goes up strong on the right side of the bucket and scores.
The understanding of Jacob Cushing as he matures, and only a freshman understanding Moran could not stop him with his height.
Lee, dribble drive, kick out, Mojica, open look at a three, and it's good. Tie scores, 61-all.
Lee creates a lot of discombobulation of the defense because of his quickness and his ball handling. Got deep, he drew the defenders in into the lane, and then a wide open Mojica, who finally got an opportunity to step into one.
Bryant lays it up and through. Delaware continues to dominate in the paint, and a timeout taken by Delaware. With 2:12 left and a two-point lead, I believe they'll have one timeout left. They must have one timeout left. The full timeout will stay right here. The stat sheet that we're looking at describes Delaware as having no timeouts left, but I doubt the Inglesby were taking the timeout there if that was accurate. So one timeout left for Delaware with a two-point advantage. How about the last three buckets for the Hens, all on layups inside, looking at points in the paint for Delaware. 46 of their 63 have come inside the painted area.
And what's interesting, Scott, since Delaware is not shooting well from long range, the fact that Drexel does not pack the lane a little bit more, and they have not been able to do that. Though Austin Williams had a couple blocks early on, they're not known as a big shot blocking team, not great rim protection because of their lack of height. So Delaware's really exposed that. Mosley getting to his left, Jacob Cushing attacking along the baseline because of his matchup. And then Darian Bryant, who I think might have one of the best, quickest, longest first steps in the game. He really has a great feel when to utilize that. And when he does, he never seems off balance to me. And that's really tells you what a fine athlete is.
If you're looking for scores down the stretch, Drexel led by Lee with 18. Williams has 17. Delaware, Daly leads the way with 19. 15 for Bryant. Mosley has 12. Hens shooting 54% this half. Drexel shooting 50%. Hens looking for another stop as they lead 63-61 after the timeout. Lee off the dribble. He's got a quick first step. Gets inside. Mojica just made one three. Can't connect on another one. And Daly, another rebound. 12 of those adding to his double-double.
That's what we call a crackback. Lee penetrates. Mojica trails behind. Good defense by Delaware. Then a tough guy rebound by Ryan Daly.
All Ryan Daly's rebounds are tough guy rebounds, so it seems. Bryant dribbling in closer. Bounce pass to Harris on the block, right side. Flips it to Daly. Daly in traffic draws the foul. And Ryan Daly, one of the best free throw shooters on the team, will try to raise the percentage for Delaware as he gets to the line. They're just 30% this half.
He's done a great job of cutting, flashing into the lane from the weak side. Let's credit Barnett Harris there for a great drop-off pass, understanding that Ryan Daly had his defender on his back. Great play by Barnett Harris, who takes a lot of pride in his pass.
Very good passer is Harris. Daly, a very good free throw shooter, now one of two tonight as he makes that one. Make it a two-possession game with a second free throw, and he does just that. 65-61. 99 seconds remaining, and Daly has 21 points on 9 of 18 from the field, 2 of 3 from the free throw line. Lee working in, good defense by Mosley. That foul a moment ago was the fourth on Rodney Williams. Now Williams calling for it offensively with 17 to shoot. The double team comes. They work it around the perimeter inside to Austin Williams. Back out to Mojica, 11 to shoot for Lee. Dribbles right side, Carter Hedges on the screen, 7 to shoot. Lee, lots of dribbling, off balance, 4 to shoot. Mojica, long range, 3 at the end of the shot clock, a miss, but Moran gets it. Lee, a corner 3 this time, and the 3 is good. Off the hands of Kirk Lee, that's his 5th three-pointer of the night. It's 65-64. A close one down the stretch for the third straight game for Delaware. A one-point lead for the Hens. 19 to shoot, 47 to play. Who will come up big for Delaware this time around? Inside to Carter. Had the advantage over Mojica, but the offensive foul is going to be called against Carter. And Drexel a chance with 40 seconds left to take a late lead.
Sadly, Eric Carter's got to understand that when you have a much shorter player on you, you do not have to be physical. All you have to do is drop step in and shoot the jump hook. He had Sammy Mojica at 6'3 on him. It just needs to drop in and score that.
Lee will bring it up. Delaware leads by 165-64. Corner Moran for the lead. He gets it. Shot clock unplugged. And Drexel on top, 67-65. Mosley will bring it up the floor and call the timeout. Drexel hadn't led since early in this second half, and John Moran's triple makes it a two-point advantage for the Dragons. We have seen this before, though. Delaware trailing late in the game versus Elon on Thursday. It was a two-point shot by Daly to send it into overtime, trailing by two against James Madison on Saturday. It was a three-point shot by Daly and Bryant, who gave Delaware the lead. Now with 25.9 remaining in this one, Delaware basketball, they can take the final shot.
First and foremost, Delaware's got to be sure they get the ball inbound. They are out of timeouts. Is there an arrow so they can maintain possession in a jump ball situation? Coach Inglesby likes to spread the floor here, allow Daly and Mosley to try to create for one another. Certainly Darian Bryant will be doing the same. I think he's staying with the shorter unit. Eric Carter going to be in and Cushing.
It's Carter, Mosley, Daly, Cushing. The inbounder will be Darian Bryant. Delaware with the basketball, inbounding near half court on their side of the floor. Mojica, Lee, Williams, and Moran in for the Dragons. They go to Daly. He's been clutch for the Hens this season. 23 seconds as Mosley brings it across. Drexel leads it by two. Daly on the wing. 17 seconds remain. Daly guarded by Williams. Three-point shot is up and in. Ryan Daly, the hero once more. 10 seconds left for Drexel. Delaware leads 68-67. Lee with the basketball. 4 seconds to shoot. 3 seconds. The freshman heaves it up for the win. It's off the mark, and Delaware has won three in a row.
Unbelievable defense by Anthony Mosley after the fantastically timed shot by Ryan Daly. He's caught the two bigs defending the ball screen here right in front of us, rises up. Unbelievably confident he makes the shot. But at the other end, Eric Carter and Anthony Mosley doing a great job with the ball screen on Kurt Lee.
I haven't seen much like Ryan Daly before. He finds new ways to become a legend here at Delaware in his rookie campaign. Time and time again, he finds a big shot and hits it, this time a three to win at the Bob Carpenter Center. Unbelievable the season Ryan Daly is having. And with that three, he is now just 2 points shy of Devon Sadler's freshman scoring record. What a night here at the Bob Carpenter Center once again.
Great tempo control, good connective defense throughout, good sharing of the ball, obviously tremendous timely play by Ryan Daly. He needs teammates to do it. Great defense at the other end in the clutch moments by Anthony Mosley and Eric Carter on the ball hedge. And I think it was that 1 minute rest that gave Ryan Daly the opportunity to have his legs underneath him a little bit more on that long range shot.
We'll ask him about it. In the post-game show here, lots to talk about. 39 minutes for Daly, and in the final 10 seconds, he hits the game winner. Another late second heroic effort by the Hens, and their winner is 68-67. We'll take a break. Coming up, the American Spirit Federal Credit Union post-game show on the Blue End Sports Radio Network.
the Sports Bloopers VHS before we hit up Thud Rockers.
Well, at least some things never go honestly.